Welcome back, family. Today, my name is Worley, and today, oops, I almost forgot that. At Donnelly Row, today in Vampyr, we're going to the hospital. The hospital. 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 Hello.
Where are we headed?
We're on our way to the Pembroke Hospital. It's just across the canal. They'll have a bed for poor Mr. Hampton.
William was... What manner of creature was he?
Predator, prey, villain, and victim. Who can say? The important thing is that he's been stopped.
Duly noted. And the woman? What... Who is she?
What woman?
Oh, don't play me for a fool. You used me to locate that skull. You must know who she is.
I thought you a gentleman. You shouldn't talk about a lady behind her back. But I will tell you, she values her privacy. Were London as peaceful as she appears from the middle of the canal? If only that were the reality of the situation.
To be honest, I've always tried to avoid this part of town.
Pembroke Hospital is the last bastion between the rest of London and the epidemic. The flu has decimated the East End, and the war still rages. Welcome to the front lines of a plague.
This is where you work, Dr. Swansea.
I am the administrator of Pembroke Hospital.
I thought you were here in service of your mysterious order, the Brotherhood of...
Of St. Paul's Stone, yes. But first and foremost, I'm a man of science. A physician, like yourself, Dr. Reid.
How do you know who I am?
No need for modesty. You are Dr. Jonathan Reid. A surgeon of some caliber and renown, if I'm not mistaken.
You are correct, sir.
I knew it! I had my suspicions. But when you took the blood sample from the corpse of poor William, I was certain. Dr. Reid. Marvelous.
I'm sorry. I'm making you sick.
Have we met?
I attended three seminars before the war. I have the utmost admiration for your research. And what a turn of fate. England's most esteemed blood specialist returns to London a vampire.
That word, again, from a so-called man of science.
I understand. Traditionally, the role of science is to refute myth, but when myth walks among us, the Brotherhood of St. Paul has dedicated its purpose to their study. There's so much for you to learn.
Of that, you are right.
He looks tired.
Let me be blunt. Join my staff at Pembroke Hospital. As a physician. I suspect you'll not find a better post of employment to contemplate your predicament.
This is sudden. I was returning home to see my sickly mother. But alas, that was before contracting this affliction.
Dr. Reid. Take a moment to consider. The post would be for the night shift, providing a good explanation for your absence during daylight hours. You'll be adequately reimbursed and have a place to hide. I even had the forethought to bring some clean clothes. So, what do you say?
It seems I have little choice, but yours is a generous offer, so I thank you.
Brilliant! Oh, Jonathan. This is one for the book, and the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Fast forward to the end of the story. He betrays me. That's my guess. That's usually what happens in the movies. Oh, we're just the best of friends. Stabs you in the back.
Thank goodness, I was beginning to be concerned.
Worry no more, Nurse Crane, for I bring good news.
Oh, Doctor, what a night. We lost two more patients. Nurse Scow said she couldn't take it anymore and resigned.
Yes, well, I'll make a new rota in the morning. In the meantime, bed for Mr. Hampton. Be sure to pay attention to his needs.
Of course, Doctor.
Oh, and Dorothy?
Yes, Doctor?
Dr. Reid here has just returned from the front. He served King and Country and will be joining us here at Pembroke. We're very lucky to have gained a surgeon of his talent, and one so experienced in blood transfusions.
That is good news indeed, Doctor.
Oh, yes. Here at Pembroke, it's not what we have, but what we haven't. It's only thanks to Nurse Crane and the staff that our ship doesn't sink. If you have any questions, just ask her.
Duly noted. Thank you.
Your assistance is required, Dr. Swansea, immediately.
Welcome aboard, Jonathan. We'll catch up after my rounds. Coming, Nurse Crane. I'm coming.
What a fucking coincidence that Jonathan's a surgeon and he's special... Oops, little leg. What a fucking coincidence that he specializes in goddamn blood transfusion as a goddamn vampire. I mean, how coincidental is that? What's going on?
Rotten or perceived, each heart contains the seeds of life. Drink at this river, dry it all.
Drink the river? It won't let me.
It's okay, Jonathan. I'll see you later.
Like, what if Jonathan was just a brain surgeon? No, it has to be blood transfusion.
Oh, come on, you bastard. I won't bite.
I will.
Please. You've lost too much blood. Calm yourself. Stop your staring and get me to an hospital, you ass! I've a mind to let you bleed out. Good luck then, sir.
All right. Sorry. I am in pain here. My guts are spilling out onto the street and you're yabbering on.
Yes. That's a very nasty wound you've got there. Take my word. I am a doctor. Dr. Jonathan Reid.
Name's Clay Cox. I'd appreciate you helping me to a better place, Doc.
Follow me, Mr. Cox. Let me assist you to that better place.
Hell. That's immersing.
Into the shadows. Dance with him the dance of life and death.
Okay, so we're supposed to fucking immerse him and lead him into the shadows so we don't get detected by civilians and cause, like, concern. But my concern is when I'm jamming my fucking palm into his forehead, citizens will probably ask questions. No.
What happened? Did I black out?
God damn it. Wait. Vampyr. Trophies. Let Clay live. Is there a Let's Kill Clay achievement? An County in the UK. What's the playroom? I don't care. Okay, back to the game that we were playing. Sorry, I had to check and see if there was a Destroy Clay achievement. But at least we got an achievement, even though it was a mistake. I kind of wanted to press X to kill.
It is wise for the huntsman to sometimes let his prey go. But no famished hunter can run for long.
It was wise because we got an achievement. But it was unwise because I hung ye. I fucking hung ye. Hello.
Doctor, where have you been? I've little time to play hide and seek with new staff members, no matter how illustrious they may be.
I found a wounded man by the docks. He answers to the name of Clay Cox. He requires urgent medical attention.
Already making the rounds? That's the Pembroke spirit. I'll ask our porter, Milton, to bring him back immediately.
Thank you, nurse. What can I do for you?
Dr. Swansea insisted we provide you a quiet office. You'll find it on the second floor with your name on the door.
Thank you. Nurse Crane, isn't it?
Yes, Dorothy Crane. Welcome to Pembroke Hospital, Dr. Reid. Your office has been prepared.
I'll ask a few questions. Like, who is Dr. Swansea?
Well, you accepted the job from him. I thought you would have known about your employer.
Apologies, I've only just met him but once. This is sudden. I've only just returned to England.
Dr. Swansea is a brilliant surgeon and the most compassionate physician.
I'm hungry for some blood.
You'll get to know him soon enough, and better than me. The administrator has better things to do than mix with us.
Goodbye.
Thank you, Nurse Crane.
I like the dialogue. There hasn't been a game on our channel that has featured dialogue choices. I'm liking it. I kind of want to just go back to the good old days and play Dragon Age Origins with the dialogue options. Because Dragon Age Origins is easily in my top 10 favorite games of all fucking time. If you'd like to see a Dragon Age Origins walkthrough gameplay, my fucking god. If any one of you says yes, I'll do it.
Right.
All I need is one. You know what? I don't even need one. I can promise you in 2018, after we play Vampyr, maybe I'll play Assassin's Creed Origins, you know, some newer games, and then I'll finish up Pokemon Quest, Crash, Dark Souls. I'll finish up the games that are ongoing. And then once we've got it down to, you know, less than 100 games that we're playing at one goddamn time, then I'll go back and play Dragon Age Origins. But there's Spider-Man coming out. There's the new Assassin's Creed coming out. There's just a bunch of stuff. 2018 is a great goddamn year for video games. There's God of War. There's Vampyr on the second floor. Okay, so we're on the second floor. Dr. Edgar Swansea, how'd you get up here so fast? What else? There's Spyro coming out. Ooh, Spyro. There's...
This must be the place.
Oh, there's Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee, which the moment that comes out, I will be playing it. I fucking fucking love Pokemon. And I'm so happy that this generation of Pokemon is going back to Kanto, the original, and they're not just shelling out 100 more bullshit Pokemon, like a trash bag, or like a keychain. Like, they're making, like, it's a remake. It's a remastered. It's not a remastered. It's a remake. Because it's not just Fire Red and Leaf Green. It's a remake. So they're doing, like, different stuff. But I can't wait. How do we use this? I guess we'll find out. Please tell me. Oh, we sleep? I guess every time we confirm our skills, we sleep. Ooh, we're level 5. Oh, it's R2. Okay, so the triggers and bumpers are all weapons. What is this? Let's analyze the fuck out of this. What happened? What happened? Back out.
Blood is much more unstable than human blood and shows extensive.
Take me to a hospital, rest in bed until the next night.
I must keep on searching. The sun is about to rise. I can feel it. I'll continue tomorrow night. I have so much time.
Well, you are immortal. Ooh, there's tactical bite and science? What's this? That's awesome. How much is it? 500. Is this passive? No, it's tactical? What's this? So 5 stamina per second when walking, 2.5 per second while staying still. Oh, that's sick. We're fucking invisible. What's bite then? Increased damage. Increased life. 3 serums. And bullets. What's ultimate? Level 10. So what's this shadow? You lose control and let the beast take over. 99 seconds. That's cool. Wait. I don't want to do that. No. Can we go back? Oh, thank God. thought we just lost 5 levels. Holy shit. Yes. If we would have just lost 5 levels of experience, I would have killed myself.
If I'm to stay here until my research is complete, I'd better learn to hide my true nature from the mortals. But what about my thirst for blood?
Nice. Well, chapter 1 is complete. I don't really want to know how many chapters there are. But if it says, I'm curious. Thank God. If it did say, that would be kind of a spoiler for me. Because I don't want to know when it ends. I don't want to be like, I don't want to be like, oh, this is the last quest. Get ready for the last video, guys. Or, oh my god, there's 2 missions left. No, I'd rather be surprised. Because it's all about the journey. It's not about the destination. So, take me to a hospital. Eternal thirst. Board the boat. Wait, what is it? Okay, so there's eternal thirst, and then there's take me to a hospital. Now, what's this? Night shift. Okay, well, we'll do that next time. Thank you all for watching. I love and appreciate each and every one of you. If you like the video, subscribe to support the channel and become a member of our family. Once again, I love you all. Excuse me. Until next time, I'm sorry about the burps. I'm a burpy guy. I'm a very, very burpy guy. Until next time. Game on.